Welcome. My name is Nadia Anderson.
My name is Shamar Davis.
You listening to Power Your Story podcast.
Season 2.
The show starring the students of Ray Graham Training Center High School in Chicago.
This season, we are exploring the power and beauty.
Amelia interview assistant principal Miss Thomas about how to have positive attitudes.
Malik talks with counselor Miss Connors about how to deal with anger.
Thank you for listening. Enjoy the show.
Hi, my name is Amelia Franklin. I'm interviewing Miss Thomas.
Hi, Amelia.
What are you doing at Graham?
I am the assistant principal at Ray Graham.
How do you get positive attitude?
Well, basically, each day I think about all the good things that's happening to me in my life, and I try to use that to guide my day. If anything bad happens, I try not to let that control my whole day. I just try to get past it so that I can remain positive.
How do you improve your attitude?
Well, I can improve my attitude by sometimes not necessarily focusing on negative things, you know, just understanding that something may have went wrong and I just got to keep going. So a lot of times I reflect and I stop and I think about what I can do differently. Or, you know, after something happened, if I'm upset or something, I take some time to think about what I can do the next time.
Why is important to have a good attitude?
Well, it's important to have a good attitude because, you know, you don't want to be walking around upset. You want to keep your mind open to new things and positive energy spread. So if I'm happy and, you know, doing good and doing well, you know, I might come across somebody who's having some issues and my positive behavior and attitude could possibly help the next person.
How do you change your attitude to others?
Well, you know, I accept people for who they are. I always expect, you know, great things from people. And if I can help them in any way, I try to help them. And, you know, I just, you know, I know that everybody's not perfect. We all have flaws that we need to work on.
Why is it important to have a positive attitude?
Oh, well, it's very important to have a positive attitude because you just want to do well. You want to, you know, keep going with positive thoughts and positive things during the day. You don't want to be upset because, you know, being upset, you know, can sometimes do damage to your health. You know, sometimes people who, you know, are upset might have high blood pressure or, you know, just shut down. And so it's good to have a positive attitude. Everything in life is not going to be happy. Everything in life is not going to be, I'm supposed to smile at everything. You're going to come across some difficult situations. But I say when you're dealing with those difficult situations, you shouldn't let them control you. You got to figure out how to get in front of it and get past it. We all have difficult things we bring from home. We have difficult things we do at work and at school. And you just can't let it control you. You deal with that situation and you keep moving.
One last question. How I improve my attitude, Ms. Thomas?
Well, you could probably improve your attitude by finding someone in this building that you can talk to when you get upset, that can help talk to you and see what the issues are and that could give you some strategies that you could use when you're feeling upset or sad or mad or something, and you know you can use when you can't get access to that person. So that's how I think you can improve yours, by locating somebody in this building that you can talk to that can help teach you some strategies to use when you're upset.
Thank you, Ms. Thomas.
Thank you, Amelia.
Mm-hmm.
what is your job at Ray Graham Training Center High School?
So I am Ms. Connors, and I am the school counselor at Ray Graham.
So you're the school counselor, and you help students with mental problems.
Well, yes, so anything that the student is feeling or they want to talk about, they can come to my office and we can talk about it.
And you know, like, I can say, like, most students have, like, anger build up in them. I think probably because they jealous, like, something they don't like what their other friends may do, like, it probably kind of throws them off. Like, at least some of them trying and most of them not trying to, you know, control their emotions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so a lot of different people have different triggers. So when people come to my office, we talk about that too, so we can identify things that they know that make them angry, so they can kind of confront it and work with it as soon as they feel that coming on.
Ms. Connor, how to control my anger?
So usually if a student is upset, I will have them come into my office, and then we talk about coping skills. So then when we are in my office talking, I give them different tools and skills so that they can practice dealing with their stress or their anger. So usually I will give them like a handout with pictures or with coping statements. And then I will have the students practice in my office. And then I will have the students practice themselves, like if they're in class or anywhere. And if that isn't helping, then I have them come see me again.
So when they see you again, what else did you do with them?
Then we will talk about what coping skills did not work and what they felt worked. So if we know that something didn't work, then we kind of take that off of their coping skills toolbox, and then we try to find other skills that might work for them. So like maybe counting doesn't work for them, but maybe like taking deep breaths or asking for a break works for them. So I try to work with the student to see what works best.
Or, like, what if that didn't work, or they could have a group or something and they express their problems?
Yeah, so some students, we actually do have, I do a group with Ms. Foss. So some students work better alone and some students work better with groups.
What can I do if someone pisses you off?
So I would say that I would probably tell that student to come and talk to me about it first, and then we could kind of develop a plan. So that you could talk to that student either with me or alone, so that you could kind of go and talk to that person and tell them how you're feeling and why, and see if you guys can come to some kind of solution to work it out. But if you guys can't work it out alone, then I usually offer my assistance to help get the two students together to work it out.
Why is it important to control my anger?
Well, because you are a high school student and we're also a training center. So our goal for all the students here is to eventually one day go on to more learning or to get competitive employment. So we want you to learn to control your emotions so that when you go out into the community, you are able to handle those problems in different situations. So like if you have a job one day, we want you to be able to know how to control your anger, or if you're at home or, you know, have roommates one day, we want you to be able to control your anger. Okay, because anger is a lifelong thing, so you're always going to have to be dealing with it.
Why do sometimes we feel angry?
Because we are human, and no one can feel 100% happy all the time. So that's just a natural emotion that everyone feels. So the important thing is just learning how to control it.
How can I be good to people?
So I always tell people, you want to think about how you want to be treated, and then you want to treat other people that same way. So if you want people to give you respect, then you have to give people respect. If you want people to be nice to you and kind to you, then you have to be nice and kind to other people.
Do you think I can be more powerful if I can control my temper?
Yes, I love that question. I think that that is 100% true. So I think that if anyone is able to control their anger in the proper way, then they can get a lot of things accomplished. Yes.
Thank you for the podcast interview, and I wish you a safe day.
Thank you.
This episode was produced by Monique Daniel and Amelia Franklin,
with production supports from After School Matters and the Creative Impostor Studios.
You can subscribe to our show on Apple Podcasts, Google Play Music, or Stitcher Radio.
Check us out on the web at poweryourstorypodcast.com.
And on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube.
Thanks again for listening.
See you next time on Power Your Story Podcast.